Hold down, man. Suitcase this. My cell phone and my charger don't walk with a limp. Get it knocked off or missing, you gon' get it. Next time I see you ass, you gon' leave airlifted. I already know, man. K-Fraud TV back in the building. Y'all go ahead, hit that like, subscribe button, and make sure you hit the notification bell so you can see it first. Okay, I see a lot of people, you know, enjoyed the last video I did when I was speaking on, you know, a couple of the DRs I caught while I was actually in Florida State Prison. As you've seen, I went in for some tattooing. I went in for a knife, cell phones, you know, being on the wrong bunk during count, things like that. Now, that was just one copy of the DRs that was actually in the bag of all the memories I brought home from prison that I did in a prior video before that one. So, for the most part, I'm gonna go ahead on this one. You know, a lot of people been hit, should have been dropped this video. But, you know, a lot of people was wondering, you know, how people get big in prison. So, you know, I figured I'd come on here and I'd speak my two cents. All right. Now, in prison, I can't speak for everywhere around the world, but I am speaking in Florida State Prison down here in the state of Florida. We do not have free weights. All right. Back in the day, Florida did have free weights, but then, you know, too many people started getting busted upside the head and, you know, they started using those as weapons and stuff like that. So they do not have free weights no more, okay? Now, they have the standard, you know, like leg machines or the bench press machines that have the little thing that you push and you pull and it's connected to the little cord that goes inside the weight and it lifts the weight blocks, okay? That's what they have down here in Florida. I wanted to speak on this is because out of my 5 years I did in Florida State Prison, that isn't the go-to route that everybody took. Not everybody took going to the rec cage to work out, all right? Like, when I was at Charlotte, you had to be part, you had to have your pass to even get in the rec yard. Like, not in the rec yard, but in the workout cage, okay? You actually had to have a pass to get in the workout cage. You see what I'm saying? So, you have people that, you know, jog. You got people that are playing sports all the time as far as, like, soccer. Okay, people play a lot of soccer in prison, believe it or not. Then, of course, you have when the championships of basketball and the football leagues and all that stuff begin. Okay, but soccer is the main thing that people actually use for cardio. All right, me personally, I played soccer a couple times. I played in the football league and I ran laps around the rec yard. Okay, so I was more of a cardio person, but I spent plenty of times working out in the rec cage, you know. Bench pressing, leg lifts, doing the butterflies, you know, all stuff like that. They even have the wheel where you get on your knees and then you roll for your stomach, you know what I'm saying? Stuff like that. But there's other things that people also use too to work out, all right? Now, I had an old school dude that was like the healthiest and the fittest in the whole dorm. And he was the oldest inmate that was in our dorm at the time. And he actually, I used to talk to him like old school, what it is you be doing? You broke it down to me that he uses his own strength as weight. So I'm like, what do you mean? And then he would basically put his arm over this arm. And as he's trying to pull up, he's pushing down with this arm. Okay? Something like that. Or he goes like this. And when he's pushing this way, he's pushing this way. And I'd be like, I don't get it. He's like, I'm telling you, that's the most best way to get big. You know, you use your own weight, your own stuff. So I'm like, all right, I guess if, you know. But old school was ripped, though. I'm talking about, like, old dude done been down 20-something years, and he believes in it, and he literally looks like he would, you know, last longer in the grid against a younger dude. Like, he got more wind, and he's got more to show, you know what I'm saying? Also, what people do is, you know, they make water bags. Or a sandbag, whatever you would want. You know, I've seen people, you know, fill up balloons, which is the gloves that they use for shakedown, you know. Or you can use, you know, a trash bag or whatever, you know, fill it up with water. And when you fill it up with water, you wrap it in a sheet and then you could tie it to the end of the broom. You get what I'm saying? So you got a big bomb of the sheet tie right there and then they curl it. And then you got the big water bomb in the middle like this. Okay, they do things like that. You can actually use a water bag to work out however. You know, it ain't got to be just pull-ups. You know, there's different ways to do it. You know what I'm saying? You could tie it in a shirt and throw it inside of a canteen bag and be lifting the canteen bag like this. All right? In confinement, And inside of like two-man cells, the main thing people use to work out is their mattress. All right, their mat. You literally roll the mat up because it's not like a regular mattress on the streets. You literally roll your mat up and you tie sheets around it to keep it tied, like to keep it wrapped up like a ball. And then you stick your hand under the sheets and you curl the mattress. You'll curl the whole mattress, get on the ground, bench press the mattress. Some people let people sit on their shoulders and they squat with the person on their shoulders, or they'll try to, you know, have someone lean on their back while they're doing push-ups. You get what I'm saying? There's different ways that people use to get big. Another thing people used is with the canteen bags, they fill it with books. Okay, they would get books from the library, you know, whether it be math books or big old history books, whatever it is. And they put that inside of, you know, the bags, you know, so they can go like this and lift it with a canteen bag, you know, stuff like that. But, you know, when you do things like that, you got to take the books out of the bag. You know, just in case they come do a shakedown, they're going to take your workout bag. You know, you take the books out of the bag and just have the pile of books under your bed, or have a pile of books in your locker, or however you have it, you know, just to make it to where, you know, if they come shake down, they don't try to take your shit because they know what you're using it for. All right. But like I said, there's a lot of people in there that, you know, they decide to come home and get big. That's on everyone's mind when they're in there. Like, oh, I'm going to work out. I'm going to give them my all. When I get out, I'm going to be like this. All right, but the one thing that a lot of people, you know, that do not mention is steroids. I've never seen so many steroids in my life other than in Florida State Prison. Whatever's on the streets is in prison. It's common sense, all right? But I've literally never seen so many people on steroids, all right? Now, I remember the only thing I ever knew about steroids myself, the only thing I ever knew of it is I seen the movie The Wrestler. And then I, you know, with Mickey Rourke, he's in the movie The Wrestler. And then he breaks it down how, you know, wrestling, they use steroids and this and that. And you see him buying it on the black market and everything like that. That's the closest thing I knew about steroids, period. But once I was in prison, I started seeing it. They had so many shakedowns. So much of it was getting knocked off. Okay, I remember one time the chapel got raided. And when the chapel got raided, they actually found a bunch of shit hidden inside the chapel, the church, not even in the dorm. And they found like 50-something syringes, you know, like 25 cycles of steroids. You know, that was just one time. There's numerous times. There's another thing a lot of people use in prison. So if you look at it like, oh, this man went to prison looking like this, and he came home like this, boy, he was in there getting it. You know, I'm not saying it isn't possible, and I'm not saying that some people don't do that. Okay, because there is some people that truly feel and believe themselves that they will give it their all, and they will literally, you know, bulk up and beef up on their own, you know, admire and heart and ability to do it. But a lot of them, boy, be fooling people, okay? There's a lot of people that will turn to the steroid, okay? Now, I don't remember all the names of the certain ones that I remember seeing in prison, but there was something called Anandrol, or something like that. There was something called Halo, and then there was another one, I don't know it off the top of my head, but it's like a common name. Those were the three that was like popular, okay? People would be like, yeah, bro, I'm on a cycle. I got an 8-week cycle, a 12-week cycle. You know, I stacked it with such and such. So they'd be taking more than one and stacking them and stuff like that. To where people literally, you know, have needles in there. Like, needles are coming like cell phones were, okay? And then people, you would see people inside the, you know, open bay bathroom or inside the two-man cells or whatever. And you'd see them, you know, sticking themselves, giving themselves, you know, the hit of steroids, okay? You've had people get sent to medical because they missed their muscle. It got all big, swollen, and their leg hurt. They couldn't even walk because they missed their muscle trying to shoot it, because the person who they had with that brought the needles and didn't bring the right length of needles. They brought shorter ones, not the longer ones. So they figured, ah, it's right there. I could do it anyways. And ended up doing it and got put in medical due to behind that. Another time I remember a dude, he ended up collapsed and fell out. Something went wrong with his insides. I'm not sure what it was. I don't know if it was his liver, his heart, his kidneys, something like that. Because he, for the last 3 years, he's been low-key, you know, doing steroids. All right? So, there's plenty of ways to get big in prison. You know, no one wants to go to prison. You know, that's on the if anyone wanted to go to prison, then they're misled in life, okay? But there's more than one way to get big. So for the ones who think, you know, one person just goes to prison and, oh, look how big he came out. Oh, he wasn't working out. He wasn't doing this. Or look how small he is. He this, that, he, you know. You never really know. You can't judge a book by the cover. Put it that way. That's simple. You can see someone like me. I done gained weight since I've been home, which is great, and I'm proud of it. But when I was in prison, I was smaller, right? All I did in prison was cardio. All I did was cardio. I did push-ups and used the work cage every once in a while, but I wasn't, you know, I didn't stay consistent with it, you know, but I would do it, you know, stuff like that. But, and look, I was skinnier in there. See what I'm saying? From cardio, box time, being stuck in the box for a shitload of time, and hitting the cage every once in a while. Feel me? But, you know, a lot of people would talk shit, be like, damn, look at him. He don't even work out, bro. He don't that, he don't that. But then they'll respect the same person who's like this. When really low key, yeah, he'll go out there and work out 2-3 times a week and shit like that. But what really is working is that cycle he's on. You see what I'm saying? So it's definitely there. You get what I'm saying? Like, just whatever's on the streets can get in prison. It doesn't matter what it is. All the way from the top of the line weapon all the way to the bottom of a Subway sandwich. If you wanted Subway in prison, you can get it. If you wanted Chick-fil-A, you can get it. Pizzas, you can get it. Chicken wings, Chinese food. You know what I'm saying? All the way to anything. It doesn't matter what it is. You know, like shit, that's just how it is. But not everyone who comes home from prison big was truly in there working out. All right? Now, they'll come home. No one's going to admit that they was, you know, taking cycles of roids and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of them will come home and act like they earned this in prison. Yeah, they earned it. They did, because they did their time and shit like that. But they was definitely, you know, in there, you know, doing cycles. All right? Stacking cycles and stuff like that. Feel me? Now, if you continue to work out, check this out. If you continue to work out, if you're known for working out, you'll have that memory muscle. Like me, I have memory muscle. If I decide to work out right now 3 weeks straight, a month straight or whatever, it'll start showing because I have memory muscle from before I even went to prison when I used to work out on the streets. I was working out. I did shit on the streets. Not right before I went to prison, even longer than that, you know? But so I got memory muscle. It kind of comes back as I get into the rhythm of it, you know, into the routine. But I would never, you know, want to do no roids, okay? Now, when I was in there, did I question to see how much it is, how much for a cycle, and you know, shit like that or whatever? You know, how much is it going to cost for this? Okay, oh, damn, $150 a cycle? $150 a cycle. Oh, yeah, but for you, boy, because you know, we get you for the yard, $100. People can get right in there, you know? And it's like, I mean, get right physically with their body. You know, like you could be real big and fat and you have an eating problem. You have your peoples drop that money in your account. You spend that money on a cycle of roids. Now you can't get money to eat and you got roids that are getting you right. So now you're gonna eventually start getting into the right rhythm. You know what I'm saying? So like I said, there's plenty more than one way of getting big in prison. Don't ever think someone went to prison and he just was working out so hard in there. He ran the yard. You know, he came out here. He, you know, he put on, you know, they're so big and bulky now that you'll believe when they was in there, all they did was work out. You get what I'm saying? Now, we don't have, like I said, we don't call it, you know, the yard down here. We call it the rec yard. You know what I'm saying? We don't be like, oh, meet me on the yard. No, it's meet me on the rec yard. You know what I'm saying? It's just, it's different. We got different lingo for different things. Now, when I speak on this video, I'm not speaking on anybody. I'm just speaking in general to, you know, people who will try to act like all they did was work out in prison, all right? And they make it seem like not anybody could do it. So this video here is basically to address the fact that it don't matter how big someone is, you got to keep it in the back of your mind. It was probably on roids up the road. And I know this from my perspective because I've seen it all. Literally seen it all. And it wasn't once or twice. Like, I literally seen it all go down. Like, it was literally like a generation through my time of seeing it. And I seen the differences in people. I seen the difference of their formation change, their attitude get up a little bit. People be snappy on that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I've seen it all with my own eyes to know, like, damn. Like, this is how a lot of people be coming home from prison big. You get what I'm saying? But no one would ever tell you that's what they were doing or that it was even in their camp, because then they'll make you think, oh, then he's probably on that shit if it was at the camp he was at. You see what I'm saying? And then same thing for, like, a fat person. Don't ever think you can't go to prison and come out like that, because, like I said, you can. They got roids. You feel me? Or you can go ahead and, like, do the workouts like I just said. Put the water in the bags. Do the water bag workouts. Put the books in a bag. Do the bag, you know, curls. Lift your mattress. You know, roll your mat up. Do it like that. Have someone help you in your workout. Y'all work out together. You know, like, there's more than one way, but it isn't specifically like you see in movies where they be in the rec cage and they be in there going ham and giving it their all. It isn't like that. In Florida prison, it is not like that. That's simple. But don't get me wrong, though. There is a lot of people who went to prison that came home off pure muscle. Like, don't take this video as if I'm saying it wrong, because I'm not. There is people out there that do it. You know what I'm saying? And shout out to them. But I don't, you know, ain't no shout out to the ones that act like that's what they did and whether they were on roids. You understand? But whatever you want to get your hands into, like I said in plenty of other videos, whatever you want to happen that day in prison, it's going to happen. You want to get in a fight, there's someone there that'll fight you. You want to swing on someone, there's someone you can swing on. Or you want to get punched in your shit by someone, there's someone there that'll punch you in the shit. You want to eat a goulash, there's someone there that'll throw down on a goulash with you. You want to rob someone, there's someone there you can rob. All the way, prison has every single thing in it that you would think of. When you wake up in the morning, whatever it is your mind is on, like, man, you know what? I'm going to stack these roids. I'm going to go get me 2 cycles of roids and stack these shits for 4 weeks. You're going to find that shit. That's just how it is, because it's prison. Prison is a world inside of a world, okay? And like I said, you know, I read these books and all. When I was in there, y'all look up this book I read. It's called Eat This, Not That. And then I also ordered the other one, Drink This, Not That. Y'all read them books right there, and it'll teach you a thing or two about this fast food stuff. Them 2 books that I was right there, you look them up, they come out with one every year. Eat This, Not That, and Drink This, Not That. And it's going to show you every single thing that you most likely loved is going to be on the not that side. All the way from beverages in vending machines, all the way to beverages at a restaurant, all the way to the food at a restaurant, everything. It breaks it down, every single thing, and it rates it from an A+ to a D. All right? I'm talking about Chick-fil-A, Chipotle, Wendy's, everything like that, and it breaks it all the way down to you. It breaks it all down. It's called Eat This, Not That, and Drink This, Not That. Those are 2 different books. Those are just books that I read. So when I read those were the books that had me on my cardio. Those were the books that made me, and everyone in there used to be like, man, damn, Fraud, we don't want to see that book, man. All that food and shit, man, you making us hungry, dog. We miss all that shit. All right, then don't look at it. It's for me. I ordered these books off Amazon myself, you know, to better me and to make me feel better and healthier. Make me not want this shit. You get what I'm saying? So, but people used to be like, damn, man, we don't want to see that shit, man. Look at all that good food. I mean, that, where are we trying to get big? We're trying to work out. What you going to do? Look at all this shit and then go back and then eat 3 soups and think it was the damn Bloomin' Onion from fucking Longhorn or Outback or whatever? You're going to think it's the Bloomin' Onion? You're going to go back and eat 3 soups because you seen the Bloomin' Onion? You know, shit like that. But those books you definitely need to check out. If you want to learn not to eat this and to eat that, go ahead and just look into that, and it breaks it down every calorie-wise. Like, it's an awesome book. And that's what I was on in there, okay? Now, you know, work out and get big, you can do that. You know, it isn't that hard. They got these gym memberships, what, $10 to $20 a month maybe or something like that. Get in there, get into these gyms and handle up. But in prison, you don't have that choice. You know, there's been numerous times we've all planned to go to the cage today. When we go to rec, we're going to go to the cage. And then when they bring you to rec, the cage is locked. They just open the cage when they feel. Now we're just stuck in the rec yard. Up, we got to figure something else to do. The cage is locked. We can't use the weight machines. You see what I'm saying? So you can't always get what you want, especially in prison. You feel me? But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this one up. Like I said, I just wanted to speak on there's more than one way to get big in prison. Okay, a lot of people will intend to it. You know, a lot of people know what I'm saying is facts. Okay, and it ain't nothing to go to prison, you know, be in there for a while and not feel right about yourself and feel like, damn, I'm not big enough, dog. After all this time I did, fuck it, dog. I'm going to do these two cycles, dog. I'm going to get on roids my last year, bro, and I'm going to blow up right before I go home. And then when I get out, everyone's going to think, damn, that boy done got big as hell in the pen. And then I'm just going to continue to work out on the streets. And it's going to look like I did all this shit my whole bid, like I fought for this, when really a lot of people didn't. You see what I'm saying? You got to just, you know, not saying everybody, though. You get what I'm saying? Like, there's not one person in my mind that I'm thinking about when I'm saying, oh, they're not, you know, I just know there's a lot of people that intend to try to use their bigness to make people look at them like, oh, this is what it is. You know, oh, look, he knows what he's talking about. He was getting big in there and shit like that. But you heard it from me, boy. 9 times out of 10, they was on roids up the road. Straight like that. That's how I look at it. But anyways, man, I appreciate y'all tuning in. I'm going to probably drop another video either tomorrow, if not the next day. I've been trying to get my gaming channel, you know. I've been trying to get my gaming channel minutes up. So I've really been like from this one and been on the gaming channel. If y'all ain't subscribed to that, y'all go check it out. You already know it's at KFrog Gaming. And I live stream and I upload on a daily. You know, I'm into more horror games. I don't play Call of Duty and shit like that. I mean, I'm raw at it, though. I do play it sometimes, but not on my channel. Okay, but I'm more into horror games. Tony Hawk, you know, skating shit, you know, like different things like that. Mortal Kombat, you know, different things like that. But y'all go check it out. It's KFrog Gaming. You know, don't meet me there, beat me there. And I hope to see y'all there. Until next time, man, you already know this is Frog.